In this video, you'll learn how to build a portal by watching me walk through the high-level flow. Later, you can build your own portal if you complete the step-by-step tutorial that accompanies the Create a User Experience course on Academy Online. A portal is a great way to extend your Appian data and workflows to unauthenticated users. These users may be your partners or customers who don't have access to your Appian environment, but still need to view or share information with your apps. They may need to report an incident, request an account, or view a dashboard. Today, I'll show you how to build a portal for the customers of Wyndham Power. This portal allows customers to easily report power outages by submitting an outage form, available from a public URL. After the customer clicks Submit, the portal launches a repairs process in Appian. I already built a couple of objects that I'll need for my portal: a simple form for reporting outages, and a process model for launching repairs. Let's start by reviewing the form and the process model. You'll build interfaces for portals the same way you build any other interface in Appian. This interface is a simple form for customers to enter the address of the outage. Because this form is collecting data locally, I use the expression mode to add a local variable, local bang outage, to store data before sending it off to an Appian process. I also already have a process model that will launch after a customer submits the form. After the customer reports an outage, the process model writes data to the power outage record and assigns a repairs task to the technicians group. After a task is completed, the status gets updated and the process ends. Next, let's update the form so that it launches the process in Appian after the customer clicks Submit. I'll select the button and will update the save value to using the abang start process function. Notice that the wizard below is assisting me with the syntax of this expression. To finish this expression, I need to have referenced the process model, parameters it uses, and provide details on what should happen after a successful submission. Done. Keep in mind, it's always a best practice to test your interface to make sure that it works as expected. I'll skip the testing steps, but you can learn how to test by completing the Build a Portal tutorial. Now it's time to create a portal object. This object will orchestrate all parts that I've built so far into a working portal. I'll name the portal object, and I'll set the display name to Report Outage. This is the name that end users will see in their browser tab. Let's save the default security settings. You can configure the portal object very quickly, especially if you already have pre-built objects. If not, the configurations pane provides you plenty of guidance to get you started. First, let's add a page to this portal. The title is what you'll see as a page name in the header bar. However, you'll only see it if your portal has more than one page. You can start building a new interface by simply clicking the plus icon, but for this portal, I'll select an existing interface. Note that you can immediately preview your portal in the branding preview. Second, let's review the header and branding sections. For a one-page portal, I can optionally disable the header. For multi-page portals, the header is required. Also, you can use the configurations in the header and branding sections to select brand-appropriate colors and add a logo. Third, let's configure the service account. A service account acts on behalf of portal users, providing the portal with permissions to connect to selected information and processes in Appian. Keep in mind that to create a service account, you should have the system administrator permissions. I'll create a new service account, and next, let's jump to this app's All Users group and add it as a user. Back in the portal object, I can now click View Record Type Permissions for the service account to see which records the service account has access to. Let's publish and save. Once the portal is published, which may take a few minutes, it becomes available to users at the specified URL. You can preview it by clicking the hyperlinked web address. I can easily test this portal by submitting a quick outage request, and then reviewing the process instance to see that the data was recorded. By the way, if you update the portal object or its precedents, Appian will automatically republish the portal to make sure it reflects the latest updates. Also, when you deploy a published portal to another environment, Appian will automatically publish the portal in the new environment. Let's recap what you've learned so far. Every portal needs a portal object and at least one interface. You can easily launch an Appian process from a portal using a Bang start process. Create a service account to handle user permissions. Add this service account to the app's All Users group or any other group that you want to use for your portal's security. Apply branding to create an experience that users can easily recognize. For additional details, visit Appian documentation.